Joining me now is Charlie Kirk, founder of Turning Point USA. Charlie, this is so sad.
You thought that's sad for Charlie Kirk. This announcement's gonna be even sadder. Those appearances with Fox News, now a thing of the past. Here he is to explain.
I'm gonna kind of not break some news, but what's missing? We don't have a single person from Fox here.
Yes.
Right? And in years past.
I gave you the opportunity just now. I was hoping you'd say.
Yeah, and I'm being nice. I love Fox. They've been very good to me.
Sure.
I hope we can heal our relationship, because for whatever reason, it's gone off the reservation since Tucker's departure.
Yeah.
I haven't been on. So it's not exactly, you know, you just look at, you just look at Grabian, no Charlie Kirk for 9 months, right? Yeah. And so we had to kind of do an event without Fox.
Yeah.
And that was a great thing, man, because sometimes sometimes desperation is the mother of innovation, right?
Yes.
So we kind of grew accustomed to love him, Jesse Waters, love him, Greg Gutfeld, but that wasn't a thing. We couldn't do it. They're not allowed to be here, right? And so we kind of sat in the conference room. We said, well, let's redesign the whole mantra. Like, let's go culture. Let's still do the politics thing. And man, what we pulled off, it's not that I want credit, but we deserve it. I'll be honest. Yeah.
You know what? I think he wants credit, actually. Yes, it's definitely a shift for Turning Point USA at their events to pivot to culture. Previously, it had just been wonky policy after policy, deep economic theory. Now they moved to the culture war. But anyway, yes, the relationship has apparently been severed. And depending on which particular quote you go to, Charlie Kirk implies that it was his choice. In some cases, right there. It definitely seemed like he was a bit confused about why he hadn't been brought on and seemed a little bit resentful, which if you'd been working with a network for a long time, I could understand why you might feel that way. And so they've moved away from having lots of Fox News personalities, and they, you know, based on what he said there, it seemed like they were a little bit like freaking out, like who do we put on? And I just think that that tells on themselves so much, like who else would we put on but the personalities from a single news network? And that's the position that you find yourself in when your politicians are jokes. You have no respect for academia or experts. You're obviously not gonna have activists because those don't exist. You just have the Fox News personalities. And what they largely replace them with is online conspiracy theorists and stuff like that. So honestly, I don't think it's changed that much. Waz, what do you think about this, this divide, this chasm between Charlie Kirk and Fox News?
Look, I'm not gonna pretend to know what's in Charlie Kirk's heart, but I'm going to guess that he hasn't read all of the works of Milton Friedman, and he's some like dyed in the wool, hardcore, conservative, free market hawk, right? I'm gonna assume that this guy's just out here playing the game, and the name of the game is dollars and cents, and Fox News being a huge platform and them shunning him, his feelings were hurt, and so he retaliated in kind. That seems to be all that's happened here. It's not a change of heart, it's not a change of anything. Fox News has cut some of the fat, and Charlie Kirk was part of that trim, and he's been wounded by it, as obvious from that clip, right? But yeah, I don't think this is some change in his ideology or his viewpoint of the world, or you know, he's got an HBO Max subscription all of a sudden. I think this is just a matter of, you know, one of his benefactors turning their back on him, and that's it.
Helen?
I know, it wouldn't be shocking if he was like, you know what, I'm gonna buy a membership to TYT. Take that, Fox News. I don't think that's happening.
I don't think so.
And I don't care about any of these people, but I do love gossip and I want the tea. Mm-hmm. Like I wanna know the tea of what went down, because it doesn't seem like he knows what went down. Like he just suddenly found himself not on the air anymore, and he was like, well, if I'm not gonna go on the air, then y'all are not invited over here.
Yeah.
But I do love your point about like that he is like nowhere else. Like it's not like he's bringing on academia or like has any other options. Like what is it now? Just a gun show. It's just a gun show. Like buy your guns and listen to even crazier conspiracy theorist guys. Because like if Fox News was all of your panelists, then those were the most moderate.
Yeah,
like you don't get less moderate than that.
Yeah, and look, there's some reports from behind the scenes on Fox, like implying that maybe the reason they made the switch was following the Dominion lawsuit. They didn't want to be affiliated with so much conspiracy theories and all that, which is an interesting theory, but like, have you watched Fox News? I don't think they've dispensed with the conspiracy theories that much. They did get rid of Tucker Carlson, that's something. But with Charlie Kirk, I know some people are probably gonna greet this news as like, haha, Charlie Kirk. I don't have enough vested interest to work myself up to that. And I don't know how much, if at all, this even hurts him or his organization. Fox News is constantly being attacked by people like Donald Trump and others. They're, despite how wildly right wing they are, they're considered to be rhinos. So, and his organization is doing just fine. They're constantly showered with money from millionaires and billionaires. They do the bidding of the wealthiest, you know, establishment forces in America. So I don't know that he needs the exposure anymore for Fox News. So it's definitely a change. I'm sure, you know, everybody wants to be put in front of as many audiences as possible, but I doubt he's exactly hurting from this.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below, because that makes you a member, and members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence, and that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.